Hey there! Today, I'll be showing you some tips for completing the Monarch's Journey challenges for Kulin Kulinich. As you might have guessed, this video is designed to be helpful for you regardless of DLC ownership, and the strategies and tips I give here don't depend on using any of the DLCs. The ones I used in this run are the ones that have been made available for free, those being the Old Gods, Sword of Islam, Sons of Abraham, and the Reaper's Dew. Check the description if you're interested in getting the Old Gods DLC for free, or if you're interested in the cosmetic mods I'm using that do not interfere with achievements or Monarch's Journey challenges. These are the rules I'm using, and let's jump straight into our challenges for today. All three of them can be completed as long as you're playing the Kulinich dynasty. First up is Not So Landlocked. Become the ruler of an independent kingdom of Bosnia and completely control all of its de jure provinces. Second, Heretical Company. Have as many courtiers as possible who follow a heretical religion. 6 for bronze, 9 for silver, and 12 for gold. Finally, Celebrating Our Independence Day. Remain independent and at peace for as long as possible. 4 years for bronze, 8 for silver, and 12 for gold. The time needs to be uninterrupted, and your progress resets every time you enter a war or your character dies. You begin this challenge as a powerful vassal on the western border of the Byzantine Empire. You also start Catholic, which is really nice since you don't need to put in any effort to join the most optimal religion. Let's talk about the Bosnia challenge first. The Kingdom of Bosnia can only be created by a special decision, which requires you to own the Duchies of Bosnia, which you already have, and Hum, which neighbors you to the south. You also need to be independent and have a large amount of prestige and a decent amount of money. There's no simple way to take over Hum, so just invite the best diplomat you can, make him your magistros, and get him fabricating. If you don't have the Conclave DLC enabled, you actually can't declare war against fellow Byzantine vassals because the Empire has medium crown authority, so you'll need to make a faction to bump down crown authority before you can start taking the territory that you claim. When the Pope calls a crusade, drop everything and commit your troops to it. Try to participate as much as you can by getting into big battles so that you get a larger share of the war chest, but you need to avoid becoming the king of whatever new land is created because you won't be able to create Bosnia by decision if you're already a king tier or higher ruler. Similarly, if you get the option to usurp or create the Kingdom of Croatia, don't do that until you already have Bosnia. Once you're loaded up on money and prestige from the crusade and have finished taking over all the territory you need from Hum, the final step is to become independent from the Byzantines. Making an overwhelmingly strong independence faction and splitting away without bloodshed is the ideal outcome, but more often than not you'll need to fight, and how difficult that fight will be depends on the state of the emperor when you declare your independence. Ideally, the emperor will be poor and weak, without the support of the vassals or any ability to muster up mercenaries to match yours. Spend your crusade bucks on mercenaries to even the odds, but don't wait too long for a perfect opportunity, or you risk having your ruler die and needing to build up your prestige to 1500, basically from scratch, by holding summer fairs and feasts every year. Trust me, you don't want to do that. Once the war is over, create the Kingdom of Bosnia, and your first challenge is complete. Oh, and hopefully this won't be an issue for you, but the de jure provinces of the Kingdom of Bosnia are just the 4 counties you start with that are in the Duchy of Bosnia, plus Imotski and Zaklumia in the Duchy of Hum. Losing your counties of Vukovar and Sirmia still allows you to complete the challenge. The second challenge, to have heretical courtiers, is just a money check, and you hopefully have plenty of that by now. The courtiers can be heretics of any religion, not just your own, but you're only going to be able to convince Christian heretics to come to you. Hop into the character finder, search for characters of your religion who aren't rulers, prisoners, or children, sort by religion, and look for anybody who has a red religion symbol signifying a heretic faith, and a yellow hand on their portrait signifying that they'll come to your court for the low, low price of 15 gold. Repeat until you have 12 heretics in your court, and the challenge is complete with your wallet just a little bit lighter. The final challenge comes as a nice natural segue from the first one. You've created an independent kingdom, now you just need to stay independent and stay at peace for 12 uninterrupted years with the same character. Preventing yourself from being attacked by the AI is impossible to guarantee, but at the very least your realm isn't within the de jure territory of the Byzantine Empire, so the largest nearby threat can't do much to touch you. See if you can marry off your family members to your powerful neighbors for non-aggression pacts, and otherwise just save up money and levies to make yourself a less attractive target for the AI. 12 years of peace is actually pretty doable, and if you're playing on Bronze Man, you can also save scum to try and avoid getting your peace streak interrupted. If all goes well, you'll unlock the third achievement after a dozen years of independent rule. I don't have a ton to say about this challenge. The RNG reliance on the third challenge could potentially be a little annoying, but otherwise you only need to wage a couple wars on the same guy, who starts weaker than you, go on one crusade and exploit the rewards from that to fight your way out of the ERE. It was just a little boring, I guess. But if you had any trouble with it, I hope the tips in this video helped. Leave a comment if you have any strategies that I missed, or if anything interesting happened in your Bosnian adventure. I'll see you next time.